Hello everybody, in this video we are going to see about oogenesis. First of all, we have to know what is oogenesis. Oogenesis is nothing but the development of a female gamete, nothing but the ovum, the development of a mature ovum. For my convenience, I am dividing the process of oogenesis into two phases, namely the prenatal phase and the postnatal phase. Take a look what happens in the prenatal phase. Okay, now consider this as a developing fetus and this is the yolk sac. So what happens in the prenatal phase is that the primordial germ cells start appearing on the walls of the yolk sac. So then the primordial germ cell keeps on proliferating. Once they start proliferating, they keep on migrating to the developing gonad of the female fetus. So that now the primordial germ cell has entered the developing gonad of the female fetus. So this process of appearance of the primordial germ cells on the walls of the yolk sac started about the fourth week of the intrauterine life. Once they start appearing, they just keep on proliferating by mitosis and then they get transferred to the developing gonad of the female fetus. Once again, I am just revising. The primordial germ cells start appearing on the walls of the yolk sac at about fourth week of the intrauterine life, then they keep on proliferating by the process of mitosis. So once they proliferate, they get transferred into the developing gonad, right? Developing gonad of the female fetus. You know that the female gonad is called the ovary. So let us see what happens to the primordial germ cell once it enters into the female gonad, that is the ovary, developing female gonad. Before discussing about what literally happens to the primordial germ cell after entering into the female gonad, I would like to mention some features of the primordial germ cell. So primordial germ cell contains 23 paternal chromosomes and 23 maternal chromosomes. Together, it does contain diploid number of chromosomes, that is 46 chromosomes and 2n amount of DNA. This structure is the ovary, that is the female gonad, a developing female gonad. All these steps happens in the fetal life. Right, since it is a prenatal phase of oogenesis, I'm just discussing all those things that is happening in the developing female gonad. Okay, this is the primordial germ cell that has entered into the female gonad. Now let us see what happens to this primordial germ cell once it has entered the female gonad. The primordial germ cell, after entering into the female gonad, that is a developing female gonad ovary, it undergoes a process called mitosis and produce two identical daughter cells, that is oogonia. These oogonia are surrounded by a flat epithelium which were derived from the epithelium lining the ovary. Right, so the oogonia gets surrounded by a flat epithelium which were derived from the epithelium lining the ovary. Within this covering of a flat epithelium, the oogonia which were produced as a result of a mitosis of the primordial germ cell starts proliferating. So it results in many more daughter cells. Of course, they are of all or of identical size. So before entering into the next step, I would like to share some features of oogonia. Since oogonia is derived from the primordial germ cell as a result of mitosis, they do have the same features as that of the primordial germ cells. So oogonia also has diploid number of chromosomes, that is 46 chromosomes, and to an amount of DNA. So now each oogonia starts enlarging and they start producing primary oocyte. So see, this is the primary oocyte. It is resulted as an enlargement of the oogonia. Okay, the primary oocyte are surrounded by the follicular cells. I hope by this time you might have guessed what might be the feature of the primary oocyte. This is same as that of the oogonia, because it has not undergone any meiosis, right? So it is just as a result of enlargement of the oogonia, primary oocyte has been produced. So primary oocyte contains diploid number of chromosomes, that is diploid chromosomes, that is 46 chromosomes, and to an amount of DNA. Once this is finished, then the primary oocyte enters into the next stage, that is it starts undergoing the process called meiosis, a reduction division. But unfortunately, it gets arrested at the stage of prophase 1 of meiosis 1. It is like behind the bars. It just gets arrested at the prophase 1 of meiosis 1. All these process takes place inside the developing female gonad, that is in the prenatal phase, that is before birth. All these process takes place, that is the primary oocyte is arrested in the prophase 1 of meiosis 1 in the diploton stage before birth, right? What might be the feature of this arrested primary oocyte is it contains 46 chromosomes. Because the reduction division is not yet completed, right? The reduction of chromosomes has not yet started, because it is arrested at the phase of prophase 1 of meiosis 1. So it contains diploid amount of chromosomes, and the amount of DNA is 4N. This is because replication of DNA has taken place. That's it. So the DNA, the amount of DNA has just doubled. So I hope all of you know that the replication of the DNA takes place in the S phase of cell division cycle. So in the preparatory phase itself, the replication of DNA has got over before the meiosis takes place. That's what the amount of DNA is, 4N. So the primary oocyte that is arrested has 4N amount of DNA. You know, since this is surrounded by a flat follicular cell, this is called a primordial follicle, right? Within each primordial follicle, which is arrested at the meiosis 1, prophase 1, at diploton stage, there is a primary oocyte. That is, each primordial follicle contains a primary oocyte, which is arrested at meiosis 1, prophase 1, in that diploton stage. Right. So before birth, all oogonia gets converted into primary oocyte. So after birth, there is no oogonia within the female gonad. So So everything will be converted, all oogonia will be converted into the primary oocyte. And also another interesting thing is, there will be about 7 million of oogonia before birth. So that means all 7 million of oogonia must have been converted into primary oocyte, right? But at birth, there will be only 2 million of primary oocyte. This is because some of the oogonia and the primary oocyte gets degenerated. Before birth itself, they get degenerated. So all the primary oocyte, all the primary oocyte within the female fetus starts its first meiotic division. Before birth itself, that is in the fetal life. It starts in the fetal life itself, but never complete the first meiotic division before birth. Only after the birth, the first meiotic division gets completed, and then it gets converted into a secondary oocyte, and then further progress goes on, further it progresses. So these are all the things that takes place in the prenatal phase. I would like to just revise what are all the important things that we must keep in the mind that takes place in the prenatal phase of oogenesis. So the first thing is about the primary oocyte. It gets arrested in the meiosis 1, that too in the prophase 1, that too in diplotin phase. Diplotin phase of prophase 1 of meiosis 1, right? So then the second point, second important point is, there is no oogonia present within the female gonad, that is ovary, present within ovary after birth. All gets converted into primary oocyte, and many of them just gets degenerated. And also the primary oocyte also gets degenerated. Once the oogonia gets converted into primary oocyte, the primary oocyte also gets degenerated. And so that only 2 million, the next point, the next important point is, the 2 millions of primary oocyte remains within the ovary. 2 millions of primary oocyte is only present in the ovary. Present inside the ovary after birth. Remaining, everything gets degenerated, even it may be the oogonia or the primary oocyte, right? So the another important thing we must remember is that the primary oocyte lies within the primordial follicle. Primordial follicle. Since as I already said, it is called as a primordial follicle because it is surrounded by flat follicular cells. So it is surrounded by follicular cells, so that it is called as a primordial follicle. Within the primordial follicle, the primary oocyte is present. So within each primordial follicle, a primary oocyte is present. So these are the things that take place in the prenatal phase of oogenesis. I hope you are clear. Hope to meet you in the next video, that is the postnatal oogenesis, postnatal phase of oogenesis. Thank you.